Okay, so welcome you guys to King's Corner. And what this is a way to highlight a lot of businesses that we've become friends with, that we've been able to mutually use each other's businesses. So I want you guys just to introduce yourself and tell everybody a little bit about what you do.
Go ahead, Linda.
Well, I'm Linda of Carla and Linda's Walking Food Tours, and we're so happy to have met you. I mean, you guys helped boost our business from the very start. This is Carla.
Yes.
We both do many things, but we do like to concentrate on the food tours because, you know, we get to show people Oceanside, the side of Oceanside that we love.
Yes, Oceanside has our heart, and we definitely love showing people around. I get very excited, even still now, when we have company visiting or whatever, they go on a sort of a tour with us regardless. So we love Oceanside.
So a little backstory for everybody who doesn't know, we actually met about, has it been 6 years now, guys?
Just about. So, yeah, just about.
Just had your anniversary, right?
Yeah.
Well, February 2022 will be 6 years.
Ah, so we actually met in February 6 years ago at Main Street Oceanside's Valentine event.
Yes, that's what it was.
And it was actually, we had just got into town starting the King's Touch, and we were waiting in line at Main Street Oceanside's Valentine event. And I think it was at the Succulent Cafe.
It was at the Succulent Cafe.
Linda, you and I were in line together, and we didn't know anybody, and we were kind of just a little lost looking around. And so we kind of walked in, got our tickets together. And as we were watching the events happen and they were getting ready to do like a speed networking, I think we looked at each other and you said, hey, how would you like to do a free food tour? And I was like, well, hey, how would you like a free video?
Yeah.
That worked out.
Kind of the rest is history. And we got to film your video, or excuse me, we got to film your tours and actually participate. And what I wanted to highlight is how amazing your events are. I don't know if people know what you guys do for the community and how you guys, at least for me, having been new to Oceanside, I didn't know a lot about the food scene and about a lot of the up and coming restaurants, and especially the farm to table chef driven food. And you guys really took that to heart. And tell me about how you really started the food tours and where that came from, your love for the food in Oceanside.
Well, what had happened was, you know, Carla comes up with this idea, hey, let's start a food tour. And it was up to me to try to implement this. And so I had gone to talk to another restaurant that had been recently opened. They were only open 2 months. And I talked to the general manager and the chef, and he has since become a close personal friend of ours, Chef Mike. And he said, we don't understand your concept, but we're in. And so we started talking to restaurants, introducing ourselves to the managers and chefs and the owners if they were there. And everybody was on board. So we just started getting the community rallied up to take these food tours. We love Oceanside, and they were exploding with food at the time. And we just wanted to show everybody what an awesome city we have, and what better way to do that than through food.
So quickly, maybe in 30 seconds, tell me what a walking food tour is. Cause you know, I know you have your professional spiel. So for some
people
know what a walking food tour is, give us a quick definition of what that is for you guys.
Well, we'll meet at a location. The tours run from 1:30 to 4:30 during tour time. So then we walk around to four restaurants. I introduce our clients to the chefs, the owners, and tell them what's happening in our area.
So the restaurants, just if I may add in my two cents, they're ready for us. And so you kind of get treated like a VIP. So
we get reservations.
So when we go, the restaurant's ready, they seat us. They already know what they're going to be preparing for us. Most of the time it's chef picked. So they decide what they want you to try. And we spend about 30 to 40 minutes at each place, so you get a feel for it. So it's not just like a walk and grab a bite and run. We actually sit down and you are served, and we tell you all about the restaurant, and so that you'll feel comfortable to come back if you enjoy it. So that's our goal, is to get you to want to support these local mom and pop shops.
Yes.
And I want to elaborate on that because having, again, we were, Sean and I were new to town and there were a lot of restaurants that we wanted to try, but we were a little hesitant. We didn't know what the vibe was. We didn't know what the food was. So it was one of those things that we just kept putting off and putting off. And what I loved about your food tour is I got to experience a lot of restaurants that I would never have even walked into. And it actually changed my mind. And a lot of those restaurants have become some of my favorite restaurants to go to. So that one thing I think that's helpful for people, tourists or people who are bringing family in, like you said, and don't know what the food scene is and don't know what the restaurants are outside of just, you know, standing and looking at it. So when you guys give people a nice snapshot, and I love that the chefs actually give you some of their food that maybe you wouldn't normally order on the menus, and they go, the chefs go over it and they tell you what it is. They give you a little backstory. And I love some of the fun facts that you guys give about Oceanside while you're doing the tours. Can you give us maybe a couple of quick fun facts of Oceanside that maybe people don't know?
Well, the biggest one is we do actually have the longest wooden pier on the West Coast. Yes. The pier here in Oceanside is a quarter mile. So, you know, if you get too full on our food tour, I tell people just walk to the end of the pier and back and you got a half a mile under your belt.
Yeah.
Pretty fun.
Uh-huh. I like one of the fun facts that you guys share on the tour, which is really something that I really love about Oceanside. And that's like the chef's collaborative, how they work together and also how they work with the community.
Oh, yes.
Elementary school. If you guys could talk about that a little bit.
Oh, absolutely. We have one restaurant in South Oceanside. He actually, the owner actually grew up in South Oceanside. His restaurant used to be a 7-Eleven he would frequent as a kid. And he has gone to the schools in the area and gotten them into like more of a farm to table thing, because kids, you know, you send them to the store, you say, we need a head of lettuce. They didn't know the difference between lettuce and cabbage. So now this is helping these kids in that they plant the seed, they grow the vegetable, they take it to his restaurant, he buys most of the vegetables from them, and then at the end of the semester, he shows them how to cook them and they all get to try it out to see how it tastes. So it's actually bringing kids closer to their food as well.
Yeah, and in turn, it's helping to fund the school, it's giving them extra money. And then as a result, he started a little thing happening in Oceanside, where I would say probably 70% of the restaurants along the coast use produce, or the organic produce from the local schools.
Yeah.
So it's really neat that
it's
they all work
spectacular.
Together. Yeah.
That's pretty awesome. And then can you talk about how the chefs work together in the community? Because, you know, you hear a lot where maybe restaurants compete with each other or there's a lot of bad blood. But with Oceanside, I love that all the chefs know each other and work together. If you guys could maybe mention some of the restaurants and chefs that work together.
Oh, yes, absolutely. Chef Daniel, he was with Local Tap House. Good friends with Chef Willie, who now has Matsu, a high-end Japanese restaurant, who also works with the brothers down at the Wrench and Rodent, Davin and Lauren. They all get together, they have fun, they go to each other's restaurants. They not only sit there for food, but they'll collaborate on dishes as well.
Yeah, that's right.
We had gone to a dinner with Chef Willie and Chef Luke at our Fila wine tasting room, and they collaborated on a fantastic dinner and they paired Orfila's wine with the meal. So it was pretty awesome.
That is one thing when we started doing the tours, you know, we were just food connoisseurs. We didn't know anything about the restaurant business or anything. And so through time we've learned things and we've definitely met, you know, a lot of people in the Oceanside's restaurant industry. And so when we would go out to eat, we started noticing like, oh, hey, there's, you know, Chef Daniel or there's Chef Willie, and they visit each other's restaurants and support each other. And basically everybody's just friendly. I mean, Oceanside, it's kind of a large town, but it's really a small community. I mean, we all, everybody's so supportive of each other. And there's definitely, I don't feel like there's any animosity towards, you know, people trying to start their new restaurants and things like that. And then the other thing that was good is that in Oceanside, technically, we're still a kind of a more affordable area for the coast. And so we are getting all these like young chefs with so much inspiration. And they're coming here because they are, I think the community and everybody's a little more willing to take a chance on them.
On the younger chefs.
And they have these great visions of food. It's absolutely incredible. So we're really lucky. I can't even believe we've been doing this almost 6 years. And that we saw it then, and now even to see how Oceanside's changed in the 6 years, it's like, wow, it really has come to fruition with us as a food destination.
Oh, absolutely.
So it's really exciting.
And even you can see the progressions of the chefs honing their particular skills. Like I mentioned, Chef Willie, he has a Matsu high-end Japanese restaurant, who hopefully will be the first restaurant in Oceanside to get a Michelin star. And his food very well deserves it. We have visited this restaurant twice, and it's spectacular. Yeah. Yeah. He imports his ice from Japan, if that tells you anything.
Yeah, yeah. It's beautiful ice.
It's beautiful ice. it really is.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Community support. I wanted to kind of give you guys a shout out, because on the recently, we did another tour with you guys, which I love doing your tours every time we're working in Oceanside. And one thing that stood out to me was, I think we're at Flying Pig, and the owner gave you guys a nice little shout out about how you guys supported all the restaurants during the pandemic, which was, as we all know, a difficult time for restaurants, businesses, communities as a whole. A lot of businesses didn't survive. And let's talk about how you guys were able to champion that and help out the restaurants.
Let me do the leeway on this one. So for COVID, it was tough for us because, you know, mostly the restaurants were closed to indoor business. So we had to shut our tours down for nearly a year.
Yes.
But Linda, in the interim, really did take point on still following the restaurants and
promoting them
and, sharing, because, you know, a lot of them had to come up with different ways to try to get business. And so she was on top of, you know, what the restaurants were doing. If there were family meals, we would go. Of course, we would have to try the family meals and let people know how wonderful they were. But maybe I talked a little too much about right now, but
that's fantastic.
She really, she definitely took point on that and still managed to keep us in people's minds too during that time when we weren't really doing tours. We were just doing the social media things. So.
Oh yeah, we were, we probably ate at the restaurants more than we do normally.
Yeah.
In order to support them with their takeouts. You know, Carla mentioned even the Flying Pig, Aaron and Roddy, we would get their family meals, and even Petite Madeleine Bakery. It's a bakery. They make French pastries, and they started doing the takeaways of their all-day buns. You could go and buy a kit and you know, from their takeout window, take them home and make your own all-day buns. So we promoted everybody. We went and we participated in their specials, and we made sure that all of our followers were doing the same.
It's pretty awesome. So if you guys could give people a quick, how they need to, like, do they go to your website? If someone was interested in a tour,
yes,
what have them do? What's the best way to contact you? How big should the group be? Just give us a quick run through of that.
Okay, well, currently we're doing tours on Saturday only because a lot of the restaurants still are understaffed. You can go to shoesandshoes.com. That's our website. You can call me, Linda, at 760-401-5968. I can help you with the website. I can issue you gift certificates. We have a lot of stuff in the making coming up. We do also, I should mention, bridal tours. We have a workshop tour for one of the local businesses coming up next Tuesday. We try to cap the groups currently at a dozen, no more than 12 people. But on the private tour, we will have 16 people. So we're very excited to be able to show other companies in our community about the food scene downtown. The bridal showers are always fun. We do birthday parties, and we do try to make sure that the person that they're celebrating is, make them feel very special.
Right. Yeah. So pretty much as long as you have, I believe it's a minimum of 4 people, you can request a private tour any day of the week. So, you know, if you have family coming from out of town, and as long as there's 4 of you, you can call up Linda and say, hey, can we do a tour, you know, on a Wednesday in a couple weeks, and she can set that up for you.
We can make it work.
So in closing, I just want to give you guys a wonderful shout out, because it's like I said, I've done many tours. My family's done tours with you guys. And just so that people know, you guys are so accommodating and generous with your time, with your information. You make sure that the whole party, that nobody's left out. You make sure everybody's dietary needs are met.
Absolutely.
If there's a mishap with orders, you guys still take care of that. I don't think I've ever had a bad experience there. And you guys just made it a despite if anything happens, whatever kind of group, if there's someone grumpy or not, you guys make the tours amazing. And I just want to let you guys know that you just make people feel welcome, make people feel special. And you guys have such a great relationship with all the restaurants and chefs that it's a great chemistry where you guys are all making sure that, you know, everybody's got the right amount. They've got, you know, the right drinks. You guys do your drink orders. So just so that people know, it's not only a great food experience, but it's also a great hospitality experience. You guys are just—
Oh, thank you. Yes.
Your customer service. So
thank you.
Well, and in turn, we would like to thank you and King's Touch very much for the videos.
Yeah.
We do see a spike in bookings when we start putting out our videos. So it has helped us tremendously. You were with us from the beginning, and I firmly believe that your videos really helped us get to where we're at now. Thank you.
I feel like they legitimized our vision. Like they made it seem more legit and more like, oh, they're really doing this. And it's really
more
happening.
Accessible.
And you guys made it, we were really lucky to have met you. And
absolutely.
We're forever grateful for that.
Absolutely.
I appreciate that. And I just want to say it's been an amazing journey just to watch you guys grow from the beginning to now. It's been pretty awesome. So
awesome.
Thank you guys for being on the King's Corner, and you guys have an amazing day. And anybody who's watching this, please check out Cardinal Linda's walking food tour.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Have a great day.
Thank you very much.